वेलकम टू दिस चैनल। मैं सेल्फ डॉक्टर टी एन तिमनाथ, डॉक्टर मॉडर्न मेडिकल साइंस, मोटिवेशनल स्पीकर एंड लाइफ कोच एंड साइकेट्री रेसिडेंट। आज इस वीडियो में हम बात करेंगे साइकेट्री एज ए करियर। क्या आपको साइकेट्री लेना चाहिए, इसमें क्या स्कोप है, इसका क्या प्रोस है, क्या कौन से, इसके बारे में वेरी शॉर्ट वीडियो में हम डिटेल्स में बात करेंगे। अगर आप इस चैनल में नया है तो चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर लीजिए, वीडियो अच्छा लगे तो शेयर जरूर कीजिए। सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट है, देर आर थ्री कैटेगरीज ऑफ स्टूडेंट, जो साइकेट्री को पसंद करते हैं, जो साइकेट्री को बिल्कुल पसंद नहीं करते हैं, और एक कैटेगरी होता है जिसको थोड़ा सा इंटरेस्ट है प्लस रैंक के हिसाब से उनको साइकेट्री मिल रहा है। तो अगर आपको लव टू द साइकेट्री है तो डेफिनेटली यू कैन गो फॉर द साइकेट्री। अगर आपको बिल्कुल साइकेट्री का इंटरेस्ट नहीं है देन बेटर नॉट टू गो फॉर द साइकेट्री। एंड दोज पीपल हु हैव सम अमाउंट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट बट यू रैंक ओनली गिव्स यू द साइकेट्री सीट्स दैट अपॉर्चुनिटी, देन इफ यू हैव सम काइंड ऑफ इंटरेस्ट देन डेफिनेटली यू कैन टेक साइकेट्री एज ए सब्जेक्ट। नाउ रिमेंबर, some people are always ask whether good communication skill is very important or very essential for the psychiatry to take psychiatry as a career. The answer is absolutely no. If you have some amount of communication skill, if you can talk with the patient for 10-15 minutes, then it is sufficient for to join as a resident in the psychiatry. Because once you chose the psychiatry, you become a psychiatrist and that will be your identity. So definitely for psychiatry, it is not that you have to have very good communication skill from the very beginning, but once you join the course and you have some interest, and definitely the communication skill will improve. How you will take the history, it will improve. So definitely if you have small interest, small communication skill, then definitely you can take up the subject. Patience, yes, definitely patience is very important. Patience and emotionally stable, these are two very important tool to become a good psychiatrist. Because you know the psychiatrist in the training period, you need to see the patient at least 40 to 45 minutes for each patient to take up the details history. But once become a psychiatrist, then the time is reduced, because this is the training period for 3 years or 3 years residency. That is the training period, and you need to know the subject in details. So definitely you have to have some patients to talk about this all the patient for an hour. But once become a psychiatrist, the time is reduced significantly. Even 15-20 minutes is more than sufficient to diagnose a patient. So definitely some amount of patience and emotionally stable. You should be emotionally stable. If you are emotionally very unstable, then it will be very difficult to control your emotion. So definitely if you have some control on your emotions, so definitely you can take up the subject as a your career. Does it affect the doctor? मतलब आप जो पढ़ाई कर रहे हैं, कैन इट अफेक्ट यू? डेफिनेटली द मेंटल इलनेस कैन अकर टू एनी वन, एनी डॉक्टर। रिमेंबर एनी नो वन इज इम्यून फ्रॉम द मेंटल डिजॉर्डर। तो मेंटल डिजॉर्डर किसी को भी हो सकता है, मेंटल इलनेस किसी को भी हो सकता है। तो डेफिनेटली आपको ये डेफिनेटली ये होता है कि आप बहुत ज़्यादा पेशेंट देखते हैं, बहुत ज़्यादा पेशेंट देखते हैं। अगर आप इमोशनल को, आप खुद के इमोशन को इसको आउटसाइड नहीं रख पाते हैं, तो डेफिनेटली ये आपको थोड़ा हैम्पर तो करेगा। लेकिन अगर आप अपना इमोशन को थोड़ा साइड में रख के पेशेंट को एज अ प्रोफेशन देख सकते हैं, तो डेफिनेटली इसमें आप इस कोर्स को ले सकते हैं, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है। नाउ रिमेंबर हाउ टू चूज द कॉलेज। द कॉलेज दो होता है, एक होता है डेडिकेटेड फॉर द मेंटल इलनेस पेशेंट, और अदर होता है कि जनरल हॉस्पिटल होते हैं, इसमें मेंटल एक साइकेट्री डिपार्टमेंट रहता है। तो डेफिनेटली ये आपके रैंक के हिसाब से होगा। अगर आप मेडिकल कॉलेज में लेते हैं तो डेफिनेटली वर्कलोड थोड़ा सा कम होगा। अगर आप डेडिकेटेड साइकेट्री हॉस्पिटल में लेते हैं तो वहाँ पर डेफिनेटली आपका वर्कलोड ज़्यादा होगा, और नंबर ऑफ पेशेंट्स बहुत ज़्यादा होते हैं, और नंबर ऑफ वायलेंट पेशेंट्स ज़्यादा होते हैं दोज आर इन द मेंटल एसएलएम्स, व्हाट वी कॉल इट, लाइक सीआईपी, लाइक एलजीबी और लाइक अदर डिमांड्स, डेडिकेटेड हॉस्पिटल फॉर द सेक्रेटरी। तो डेफिनेटली आपको रैंक के हिसाब से उसको लेना है। नंबर ऑफ पेशेंट्स आपको देखना है, इंडोर फैसिलिटी है कि नहीं देखना है, क्योंकि इंडोर फैसिलिटी इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू लर्न द बेसिक ऑफ सेक्रेटरी। इंडोर फैसिलिटी होना चाहिए, ईसीटी है कि नहीं, आरटीएमएस है कि नहीं, एटलीस्ट ईसीटी आपके पास होना चाहिए ताकि ईसीटी आप दे सके और ईसीटी के बारे में डिटेल्स आप जान सकते हैं, इसका इफेक्ट कैसा होता है। तो डेफिनेटली ये सब चीज़ आपको देखना है। लैंग्वेज बैरियर, ये हमेशा लोग बोलते हैं कि साइकेट्री इज ऑल अबाउट द हिस्ट्री, हाउ यू एलिसिट द हिस्ट्री, इट विल गिव यू द डायग्नोसिस। नाउ इफ यू हैव लैंग्वेज प्रॉब्लम, Does it, you, should you take the subject as a career? Like if you are from the North India and you get the seat in the South India, so should you take the this college? No, number one, if there is any other option, you should choose for that. But if you are very interested for the psychiatry and only the barrier is the language, then definitely you can go for it, because language barrier is not a very big barrier. Definitely you can learn the language, you can learn how to practice the language, and you can take the history very easily. There are so many psychiatrists, they have done the degree, they have done their residency in the state where they do not know the language. So definitely if you have a very keen interest on the psychiatry and you are getting only the college where the language barrier is there, then definitely you can take the subject and you can learn the language within 1 year, and you can start very good practices in history taking. Now, stigma isolated branch we'll talk about in pros and cons. Consultation license secretary we'll talk about details. Time definitely ye bhi pros and cons mein aate hain. It is a easy branch, definitely PG mein koi bhi easy branch nahi hota hai. There is and number of information you need to study in depth. So definitely no subject is inferior to any other. Definitely you need to study in depth. End branch, someone will tell it as an end branch, but no, it is not an end branch. It has child secretary, DM, it has geriatric secretary, direction secretary, forensic secretary. Definitely you can have this DM as a super specialization in the secretary, as well as there are so many fellowships are available from NIMHANS. You can definitely go for this. Now, if you talk about the pros, number one, the most important is the work-life balance. Yes, definitely there are work-life balance. In the residency, you will get some emergency duty, but once you become a psychiatrist, there are very, very less number of emergency duty and emergency calls. So definitely you can have a better, good work-life balance. Demand is increasing per year. The number of psychiatric illnesses are coming more and more, and the demand for the psychiatrist is increasing, but the number of psychiatrists are less. So there is a demand or supply gap, and that is the beauty of the subject, that even with your MD degree you can have a very good practice. Now that's why you settle early rather than any other branches. Psychiatry is a branch where you can start your practice very early, and you can have a very good number of patients inflow in your clinic, and you definitely have a better settlement or early settlement. Now, less investment, definitely you don't need anything. You just need a table and chair and sit and consult the patient and charge for the patient, and definitely you can earn a handsome money. So there is less investment in any other. Basically, if you are from the surgical background, now everything is investment, investment and investment. But for the psychiatry, you have almost zero investment, and you can start earning from the day of your clinic. Now, going abroad is very easy. If you are planning for going to abroad, UK and Australia, these are the very good options for the psychiatrist. So definitely you can have a better choice for going to psychiatry. Research, definitely psychiatry is a branch where you can have a tremendous research, but you need to go to that institute where the research are very very genuinely done and very interestingly done, that like NIMHANS, AIIMS, PJ. And these are the institute, premium institute for the psychiatry. You can go there and you can have a better psychiatry research program. But the cons, if you talk about psychiatry, it is all about the stigma. It is stigma is for the patient. Basically, those are in the lower smaller cities, they are having more stigma, but in the metro cities the stigma is less. The patients are coming to the doctor, they know the mental illness. The growing awareness is reducing the stigma in the metro cities, and it needs some time even to reduce the stigma in the smaller cities. Lack of jobs, yes, definitely if you are a person those who likes actually doing job, the government job or private job, the number of jobs for the psychiatrist are less, because in the private hospital, in the corporate hospital, they don't give you job on the basis of salary. They give you job on basis of patient, number of patient. So definitely if you want to have a very settled job, then it will become little difficult for the psychiatrist. Less super specialization, yes, number of seats of super specialization is very, very less, but still they are growing. But at that point, the benefit of doing super specialization is not very big than doing MD secretary. Even with MD secretary, you can have a better क्लिनिक और यू कैन हैव बेटर पेशेंट इनफ्लो टू योर क्लिनिक. सो सुपर स्पेशलाइजेशन इज नॉट ए वेरी डिमांडिंग नाउ इट इज, बट इफ यू हैव ए सुपर स्पेशलाइजेशन ऑन चाइल्ड सेक्रेटरी, डेफिनेटली द इंक्रीज डिमांड ऑफ चाइल्ड सेक्रेटरी इज देयर. सो यू कैन हैव ए बेटर क्लिनिक, बट विद द डिग्री ऑफ एम डी सेक्रेटरी डेफिनेटली यू कैन हैव ए बेटर वर्क लाइफ बैलेंस, a handsome of income, and definitely you can lead a better life. So definitely if you have little interest or inclination towards the subject of psychiatry, definitely you can take psychiatry and you become a psychiatrist and you lead the practice. Now remember, there are three important subjects. One is your forensic medicine, another is anatomy, and another is psychiatry. These are the three important subjects. Those who don't like, it's very difficult to pursue the degree in this course. But if you like, definitely these are the beautiful subjects. Thank you so much.